There we are, and a warm welcome along to our first Tuesday Live United Kingdom talk. A warm welcome along to you. I always get in such a state. Let me just turn something down. I always seem to get in such a state before I do a show. Honestly, I mean, last night I was working hard, preparing all little bits of paper and things like that. And I've done the same this morning. Got up at 9:30, had breakfast, got all my bits and pieces together. And I seem to not be ready until about 30 seconds before I've actually done the show, and before I'm ready, before I'm sitting here. And I'm still not ready. I've just realised, since I started talking only just 30 seconds ago, I've just realised I have a stack of bits of paper over here, ready to do emails and things like that, and I haven't got them ready, so I'm just gonna reach over and get these. I've already got some emails here, because what we wanted to do. Oh, by the way, if you don't know me, good morning. It's just gone 11 o'clock here in the UK. My name's Chris Reardon. This is my twice a week talk show, United Kingdom Talk. Now, I've been doing talk shows in a recorded form for the last 5 years now, and we've kind of done a couple of experiments with live shows, but sometimes the technical side of things just completely and totally defeats me. And a few weeks ago, I'd really taken on quite a lot of work one way or another, whether it was this or something at night or something like that, and it all became a bit much. And then we started the show one day, and I kind of crashed. Do you know what I mean? I kind of crashed and I thought, nope, not doing that anymore for a while. Okay, so here we are again, and I'm hoping to kind of try and combine the live show and the recorded show together. Now, the reason for that is, I asked a few regular people that have been with the show for many, many years now, and some people prefer the recorded, some people would prefer the live. But one of the reasons given for people preferring the recorded show was, one, we can do them outside. Okay, as I say, if you're new to the show, you won't know this, but sometimes I take the camera out, might be in a forest. I've done a show in front of Sydney Opera House, all places like that, all over the place. So we can still do those. But with a live show, of course, it's very instant. The other thing with a recorded show is that it gives you time. It gives you time for people to kind of think about whatever subjects we've chosen to chat about, and then put an email together. It's all much more kind of, what would you say, sort of relaxed. You know what I mean? You can sort of relax and take your time at writing an email, rather than just suddenly quickly picking up a Skype phone and sending a quick message. I mean, I find sometimes when people send messages on Skype, what happens is they wait a while and then they send a message, and then kind of by the time you've got the message through on the Skype, you've moved on. And then you look at the message and you're thinking, what was he talking about there? You know, so but with the recorded show, you get time to sit there, write an email, send the email in, and then it can be recorded for the next show. So I've been trying to find a way of combining the two shows, and I think I've come up with it. I've got my emails here that have kind of been waiting since the last show. Not only that, but a package has arrived. Look at this, dear. Look at this, a package has arrived all the way from Hollywood in Florida. I mean, how marvellous is that? Someone has bothered to send something from Florida. Now, I have a feeling I know what this is. I'm just going to have a... And I've got a cup of tea next to me as well. I have a feeling I know what this is. Now, shall I open this now, right at the beginning of the show, or not? Eh? Should I open this now? Or shall we do a few little bits and pieces? I don't know. I think we'll do a couple of bits and pieces for you to start thinking about if you want to join in today, okay? Now, one of the emails that's come in was from one of the subjects that we chose about the other day. And here's the subject. Do you remember what you did before computers? What did we do? Now, I'm 47. I know those of you that are watching the show are thinking he doesn't look 47. I know that. I know I don't look 47. I'm very, very young. Very, very young looking. But my true age is 47. Now, you're not to tell anyone that, okay? It is, as they say, our little secret. There's an expression I expect one or two of you have heard before. It's our little secret. Now, let me just do something on here. One second. I forgot to put the Facebook, mate. I always forget to do things. I need to have a producer, I think. Someone who will take all the clerical tasks off my hands, or I can just sit here and rabbit on. Right, hang on. Now. There we are. Sorry, I can't do two things at a time. There we are. That's done now. Yeah, now what did we do before computers? Do you remember? Because I don't. That's the strange thing about it. I've lived here where I am now. I live in Royal Berkshire, in Bracknell, a town called Bracknell. I've been here since 1992, and I have always had a computer here. Haven't always been online. I think I went online about 93, 94, so still been quite a long time online. But in my flat, where I had a flat in Wandsworth, even there I had a computer. It was an Amstrad 6128. It had a massive 128 bytes of memory in it. Do you remember that? And before that, I had a Sinclair Spectrum. And I think from the first day I had a Sinclair Spectrum, I was just fascinated but confused with how these little things worked. I really was. Now, I brought this subject off because we brought the subject up in one of the other shows. Okay? And Vicky, the wonderful Vicky, has already sent a Skype message in this morning telling me that the video is a little bit jumpy. Well, just listen then. If the video is jumping, just listen, my darling, okay? She's already written in an email on this subject. And she says, "Hi, Chris. On Tuesday, June the 15th show, you asked, what did we do before we had personal computers?" She says, "One, television. I definitely watched more TV. In fact, I would actually sit down and watch a TV show or an old movie from beginning to end. Was my ability to focus on one thing better back then, or were the shows better? Perhaps a bit of both." Oh, I think you're right there. I think you're right that the shows were definitely better. I mean, as a child in the 70s and 80s, I do definitely remember people kind of making... spending time on making TV shows. You know, you see these programs now, and some of them are just so badly edited or badly put together, don't you think? I mean, certainly here in the UK, and apologies to the Americans, but when I went over to the America in 96, and that was my kind of first insight into how American television is, I thought it was a bit kind of slapdash. Now, television here in the UK never used to be like that. On the other hand, I wasn't in the States in the 70s and 80s, but certainly now, I think again television here in the UK has become slapdash, where it's not done properly. People haven't thought how to put the programmes together. You come out of the programme, you know, it used to be that you would come out of the programme, there would be a little music, there would be a caption with the programme title, which would hold for a few seconds. And then it would be what we call a station ident, or a bumper, which would say Thames Television or something like that, at end of part one, and then into the adverts. And it was all very smooth. Now it's like chop, 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 chop. And it's almost like, oh, we've done that job, let's move on. There's no pride in it now. So I absolutely think you're right. I definitely think television was better in the 70s and 80s. What do you think? I'll open the phone lines in a minute. if there's anyone that wants to call in after we've done the one or two emails here. Okay. Watching a TV show from beginning to end, Vicky says. Now, you know what, Vicky? I am the same. Today, just before I came up to chat to you for an hour, today I was watching a programme downstairs and it's like the fifth part of this show that I've watched. The show is an hour long. It's called The Strictest Parents. I mean, if we get time, I'll talk to you about that. I don't think we're going to have time in our little hour to do that. The programme was called The Strictest Parents, but I've watched it kind of in five bits. You know, I watched a bit yesterday afternoon. I watched a bit before I went to work. I watched a bit when I came home. Okay, from work. I watched another bit this morning, had my breakfast, watched the last bit, and then came upstairs to talk to you. Now, I never used to watch television in bits. And I find myself watching the television and then coming up, or I just pop upstairs and do a little bit of work on the computer, you know, for the show, actually, doing a bit on there, then popping back downstairs. And I never watch a whole TV, even Doctor Who, a programme that I love. Doctor Who. I don't watch a whole episode. I watch half of the episode before I go to work, and I watch the other half when I come back. And are we like kind of doing ourselves out of enjoying programmes here? Computers have taken us away from everything. I think one of the problems, I've just dropped my pen, just a minute, where's that gone? Yeah. One of the things I found in that last live show I did, when technical things went wrong and I threw it all up in the air and I thought, right, that's it for a while, and I walked away. But there are times, for example, I'm quite enjoying sitting here chatting to you at the moment, right? There are times when I sat here for a few hours and you're typing away, doing something on your computer, and then you think, oh God, I've got to get out of this room. I've just about had enough. Are we becoming technically phobic, all of us? Those of you that are a bit younger, and I know we've got Mikey Holt, our 15-year-old, watching and listening this morning. I wonder if that will happen to you. You have been brought up. Computers and mobile phones and things like that have always been there since you were born. Multi-channel television, you know, hundreds of TV channels. They have always been there for you, haven't they? When I was little, there were two television channels. BBC One and ITV. BBC Two came along when I was a child. Channel 4 a little bit later, and now Channel 5. And now hundreds and hundreds of television channels all showing rubbish. There's so much rubbish. I've never understood people that can sit there and watch the likes of Big Brother. I don't get it. Why do you want to sit there and watch 10 complete freaks making fools of themselves and pretending to be people that they really aren't? Me? This is me. What you see and hear today is me. What you see and hear on that awful, awful programme, Big Brother, is the image that they want to portray to you. And quite frankly, how many of these people find boyfriends and girlfriends after they've been on that show? I don't know. I mean, would you really want to mix with any of that lot? It's just awful. Where are the big variety shows that we used to see? People taming lions on a stage. Singers. But good singers. Sometimes you turn a programme on now and they have some musical show on and the singing's diabolical. Does anyone remember the Song for Europe programme a little while ago? Or was it Your Country Needs You, I think it was called? Just dreadful. Six singers on there competing for a competition, five of which were completely out of tune. How did they get that far? Who on earth put them on the television? It's just a disaster. And we see this time and time again. Programmes that seem to have been thrown together at the last minute. I mean, one company that I have to say stands out for making damn good television is Talkback Thames. They made the recent Dorothy programme where they were looking for someone to play the lead role in Wizard of Oz, which is coming to London soon. Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber. There's someone I'd like to meet. Would you like to meet him, Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber? We've got that. They make The X Factor. I think they make Britain's Got Talent. But it's done properly. The programme is edited and cut together perfectly. The sound levels are fantastic. It works. OK, Simon Cowell sits there all smarmy. He knows what he's doing, though, doesn't he? Why has television lost that pride? And certainly, the same can be said for certain radio shows. Have you listened to radio on FM or indeed on internet? Where the presenter just doesn't seem to bother. What's all that about? Where has the pride gone? So yes, I see exactly what you're saying there, Vicky. I do think the shows were better, both on television and radio. But I also think that the computer has kind of stopped us from doing other things. Until we get to the point, as I did a few weeks ago, when I thought, right, that's it, I'm out of here. And I left, I stopped doing the show 5 minutes after I started doing it. Not very good, really. Very unprofessional. But I just had enough. I couldn't sit in front of a computer any longer. And I left the house. I went out on my bike. Funny, isn't it? Vicky says, on the subject of newspapers, I was asking about newspapers and what you think of them. She says, I've always read the newspapers, but we were very limited to only the local papers because she lives in Hollywood, is it the Hollywood or is this another Hollywood? I'm not quite sure. She says, now I have a fairly good internet connection. I can indulge in my UK favourites, the Daily Mail and the Telegraph. Oh, I've got Daily Mail here. Look at this. Look at this, a real Daily Mail. Look at that. I tell you what, Vicky, have you ever held a copy of the real Daily Mail? Would you like me to send one so that you can have it in your house? Because I know what you blooming Americans like. You collect things, don't you? You collect things. Did you hear a couple of years ago, people were actually, it's a dreadful thing, some English person was actually collecting water from Princess Diana's fountain in plastic bottles and selling it on eBay. And people from America were buying this stuff. Why on earth would you want a bottle of water from Princess Diana's memorial fountain? Is that illegal to do that? Am I missing out on a business here? Eh? I think I might be missing out on a business here. I don't know. Could I say, would you be interested? I wonder if anyone would be interested in actually purchasing water from my house. A bottle of United Kingdom radio water. Now, how does that stand? I'm actually drinking a cup of tea at the moment with water made from the United Kingdom radio tap. Do you think there's any chance of me selling water to the public on eBay? Chris Reardon House Water. What do you reckon? Would that work? How much could I charge? Huh? On the subject of shopping, Vicky says, because we're talking about shopping. Now, I don't like going. I know it sounds mad. I do not like going shopping. It bores me to tears. Okay. Slight lie there, lads. If you want to take me into a technology shop with audio or computers, televisions, might be interested in that. Clothes shopping? No, thank you very much. My sister, oh my God. Well, my sister lives up north in Woodall Spa. And I no longer go shopping with her. Because we go out for something in particular. I said, oh, can we just pop in Debenhams? And then she goes to the clothes section and you can't get her out. She doesn't buy anything. She sits there picking up dresses and bras and knickers and I just want to go. So I no longer go shopping with my sister, which has peeved her a bit, really. I hand her a bit. I go shopping, sis, and I'll give her a bit of money. And she, oh, are you coming? No, I'm not. No, I'm not coming shopping with you. The only people I now go shopping with are my two nephews and my best friend Ron, who's downstairs at the moment and keeps threatening to come up here and interrupt the show today. He's stayed with me. I've employed my best friend to do my kitchen floor. I've got a slate floor downstairs, which hasn't been made shiny and all that business. Anyway, on the subject of shopping, Vicky says, can you hear that helicopter? There's a helicopter going over. It's protecting me. Do you hear that? It's protecting me. Because we may be attacked at some point. By the way, this show is live. How do you know it's live and not record? Well, you might be listening to recording. It's, if I tell you, it's Tuesday morning at 22 minutes past 11 now. If you check your clock and that is indeed the time, UK time, then you know this show is live and you will be able to call in very shortly. Okay. But not yet. Don't rush me. Don't rush me. Shopping, especially for clothes, Vicky says. I used to spend a lot of time looking for bargains in the stores, but now I buy almost all of my clothes on the internet, which saves a lot of money and time. I can recommend eBay for that, actually, Vicky. If you're not bothered about fashion, which I'm not bothered about fashion, check on eBay for the clothes you want. Often you can find some real bargains on there. I have bought secondhand T-shirts on there. There's nothing wrong with them, dear. Nothing wrong, dear. And they're like pennies instead of pounds. Or they're cents instead of dollars. Did you notice how I quickly changed my monetary systems just for you then, Vicky? Eh? She says, also, I accumulate points when I use my credit card. Me too, my love. Oh, yes. I get cash back in January. I like that. I cash in those points for free clothes. I was able to get a winter coat and a pair of winter boots for free via the internet by saving up credit card points. Oh, I've just got a pair of boots off the internet. Would you like to... are you watching this? You see, some people are watching the show, some people are listening. I tell you what, for watching, let me see if I can get Ron to bring up my boots. Just a minute. Would you like to meet Ron, my friend? Would you? Just a very quick appearance then. Just a minute, let me see if he's down there. Ron! Could you bring up my new boots, please? Thank you. They want to see you. Right, I'm just going to bring... This is my best friend. He's downstairs. We're going out for a bit of lunch later. So he's going to try and make me spend money because he loves shopping. Oh, yes. Yeah. He buys all these be coming up in a minute. He buys all these expensive things. He doesn't spend anything. You know, £100 on one shirt, £100 on a shirt, £65 on a pair of shorts. I mean, he's off his head, and he thinks he's going to get me to spend money today. Oh, you're there already? Are you going to come and say hello?
I've got to do my hair first.
What do you mean? No, come and say hello.
I've got to do my hair first.
Oh, no, he's gone now. There we are. That's it. Here, look at this. Boots from the internet. Now, these are Dr. Martin boots, okay? Now, the reason I bought those, very good. How much do you think these were on eBay? These are £80-£90 in shops, okay? £40 on eBay. And they are the real ones. Oh, I love that. Oh, I love that smell. I shouldn't really like the smell of leather because it's dead animals, isn't it? But, oh. Don't you love the smell of a new pair of leather boots? Oh, you know, I might wear these later just for the smell. Sometimes I wear them in private, in bed. With nothing else on, just the boots, because it's a nice smell. And you can, if you put the sheet over your head and smell the boots. Oh, it's lovely, beautiful smell, dear. Anyway, so Vicky, there's my advice to you there. Look on eBay, my darling. Okay, look on eBay for anything, any clothes or anything like that you want to buy. Okay. She says, if you really, and you really struck a chord with me in one of your shows, when you talked about the problems we used to have with old PCs. Oh, yes. Now, this show is exclusively on computers, isn't it? And Wi-Fi radios. So you will know exactly what I mean. Maybe you're on your second, third, fourth computer, perhaps. Do you remember the first one and the problems you used to have with it? Do you remember that? She says, you mentioned Are you all sitting down now? The blue screen of death. Do you remember that on your computer? The blue screen of death. If you've got a new computer, has that happened to you since you've bought a new computer? Bet it hasn't. Or very, very rarely. Doesn't happen to me anymore. We no longer get the blue screen of death, do we? And thank God for that. I remember tearing my hair out sometimes. Tearing my hair out. Trying to get a computer to work. It was a nightmare. Absolute nightmare. She says, you mentioned the blue screen of death. My first PC was a green screen DOS-based IBM back in 1985. She says, remember DOS commands? No, I don't actually. That's after. That was before I ever bought computer. Oh, hang on a minute. I had the Sinclair Spectrum. Did that have DOS commands on it? I don't think he's going to come back up. He's got all shiny. He threatens to come on the show, right? But I've just heard the Hoover going on downstairs. What's that impulsive? You know when the people get cleaning all the time? He's one of those. Oh yeah, terrible. I was in his. He's got a flat in London. I was in his flat the other day, and I went to wash my hands in the kitchen sink. Don't wash your hands in there. I said, I've got to do food in there. Don't wash it. Oh, my God. He said, look, you're dripping it all over the floor now. I love it. Love it. Back to the email. She says, back then you had to pay for email accounts. Did you? I've never paid for an email account. Well, that's new to me. She says, now we expect email to be free. How much longer will that last? Well, that's interesting you see that, Vicky, because I have a feeling that email is not used so much now. I think it's all Facebook messages, isn't it? Everything seems to be... I certainly don't get as much. I mean, I think most of my email now is spam, to be honest. I think it is. Most of the email now is spam. She says, also, we buy PCs, laptops, and they are great value for a while. Then the websites get fancier with more Adobe Flash players, features, and the programs we use get more sophisticated. And those updates that are supposed to support certain operating systems sometimes seem to do more harm than good. Before you know it, your fast PC seems slow, like someone poured molasses into the works. My current PC is okay. As it happens, it will turn 3 years old this week. But it runs on Vista, and the last updates have definitely caused the PC to slow down, freeze up, go all white and frosty looking. Well, you can always do it. You can always go back, can't you, Vicky, to a point where it was working correctly. I wonder if the update didn't work properly. Do you know how to do a system restore? Do let me know that, okay? If you know how to do a system restore or not, Vicky. She says, I looked into upgrading to Windows 7, but found it would not be compatible with my PC. No, and the other thing is, if you want to upgrade to Windows 7, you have to do a clean install. Do you know what that means? You have to blank your computer back to factory, okay, and install with nothing on it. So be warned with that one. I mean, they all make it sound so easy. Oh, it's all right if you back everything up first. It's not easy, is it? How long does it... And is there anything else, right? Is there anything else that you can buy that goes out of date within 6 months? It's just unbelievable, isn't it? All these updates and upgrades and, I mean, God knows how much it must cost businesses to continually upgrade their computers all the time. What a nightmare. It must cost them a fortune. Always upgrading. Every few years, got to chuck everything out and start again. I mean, there is nothing else, is there, like IT? Is there? And computers. She says, which leads me back to the words of your friends who used to help with your computer problems. Someday we will always, laugh about this, as indeed we are now. Let's be honest, the computers today are fairly stable. We don't get the blue screen of death anymore, do we? It's much, much more stable. Much, much better. As I say, I used to be screaming down the phone at people, blaming them because there was something wrong with my computer. Friends, God knows how they ever put up with me. I do not deal with problems with computers very well at all. I can do audio, I can do wiring, I can do a bit of electrical work. Computers, nightmare. And how many times have you had a problem with a computer? You've sat there and tried to sort it out for hours. It doesn't work. You've turned it off, gone to bed, come up in the morning, thought, oh, I'll work on it a bit more. You've turned it on and it's just worked. And yet you didn't do anything. Artificial life, if you ask me, dear. I think these computers are alive, dear. I really do. They are alive. Aren't they? They absolutely are alive, these computers. She says, I think the types of computer problems we have been confronted with have changed throughout the years, but I also think that we have been persuaded or perhaps even trained to believe that computers have to be replaced every 3 or 4 years or you will fall hopelessly behind with the current leap technology. What do you think? Take the operating system. Windows 95 always used to crash. 98... used to crash. When we got to XP, it didn't crash anymore. And since XP, I've gone to Vista, whenever I build a new machine, gone to Vista, and my new laptop has got Windows 7 on it. Did we need to go to Vista or Windows 7? I don't think so. It's all about keeping the money rolling into Microsoft and whatever other software company, isn't it? Do you know what? I still use the same piece of software for editing my photographs that I've had for the 10 years. And they're always saying, oh, would you like to upgrade? No, I don't want to upgrade. This works. Why do I want to upgrade? And they've kind of got so many people into this thing, whereas ever there's an upgrade, oh, they buy the new one. Well, you don't need to keep buying the new one, surely. And it's not cheap, is it? I mean, how much is Norton virus thing? How much is that cost every time? There are lots of free virus checkers. Yes, are they? I wonder, you know, but I do worry. That's the one thing I do spend a bit of money on, my virus thing, annual virus thing. That worries me. I have had a virus once before, years and years ago. You don't want to go there. Lost everything. So I wonder, you know, are the free virus things as good as the ones that you pay for? I don't know. She says, how many years do you expect your computer to last? Now, here's another thing. Now, when I'm DJing or doing my karaoke, I rely heavily on a laptop. Therefore, I change the laptop every 2 years. It's out virtually every night of the week. It gets knocked about in the car. It gets knocked about at work. So I change it every 2 years, worrying that it's going to stop working. So I buy another one 2 years later. But here's the thing. I am now on my fourth laptop for work that I take around, okay? So that's 2, 4, 6, about 8, 9 years. What do I do with the other ones? I give them to someone. Give them to someone who's, you know, perhaps can't afford a laptop. Please take that. I'm glad that you found a use for it. And do you know what? Every one of those laptops is still working. One of them is 6 years old and is on 24 hours a day and runs the music in a pub. So I think they last a lot longer than these people are telling us. I really do. She says, I've come to believe, rightly or wrongly, that spending more does not necessarily make the machines last that longer. Yes. Yes. Now, although I buy a laptop every few years, I don't buy a top-of-the-range one. Nowhere near top-of-the-range. In fact, I buy usually the cheapest, most basic model. £300 to £400 is what we're paying at the moment for those. My last one, about £450, is a Dell. OK. Interestingly enough, one of my friends who lives in Brighton, he buys the top of the range and he doesn't listen He doesn't listen to people. I tell him, why have you, what do you want it for? And he says, oh, just to go onto the chat rooms and do emails and stuff. He doesn't do anything like I'm doing here, you know, like radio shows, anything like that. Doesn't watch a bit of video, perhaps, anything like that. Doesn't do any of that. All he wants it is to chat to people online. That's the sort of thing he does. Okay? He bought a Sony Vaio. £1,500. And I said, well, why'd you buy? Oh, it comes with all this software. I said, well, what are you going to use? What are you going to use? What a waste of money. Not only that, but it went wrong after 2 years. So, no, I do not think that you need to spend a lot of money on a laptop. Although I personally would go for, a branded name, I don't know, Dell, Toshiba, Compaq, something like that. I would go for a branded name. I don't think I'd touch the really cheap end ones. There are some very, very cheap ones. Wouldn't go near those. But maybe you've got one of those. Have you got a really cheap laptop? She said, must go now. The cat is causing all sorts of trouble. Now he's trying to unzip my handbag. A few more minutes and he will figure it out. Don't you love your pets? I've got to take my cat to the vet later on, 3:30. I noticed yesterday, because she turns over in the garden and likes her chest rubbed, and I think there is a tick attached. And you're not supposed to remove ticks because the legs can break off in their bodies and then you get infections and it's very difficult. So you take them to the vet and they know what to remove them. Vicky says, glad to hear you'll be doing a live show again. Well, here we are now. Have fun with it. I will have to leave for work in 20 minutes past the hour, but we'll keep listening via the iPhone app. Is anyone listening on an iPhone? Are you listening on an iPhone app? Anyone? If I crank up the volume and put the phone in the cup holder, voila! Instant internet radio in a car. Best wishes from Vicky. Thank you, Vicky. Nice to hear from you, my mama love. I've got a Nokia phone. And unfortunately, I cannot listen to internet radio stations on that, which is rather disappointing. Now, I'm going to open this little parcel here, which the lovely Jennifer sent in. Here we are. Got an address as well, you see. We've got a P.O. box here. If you want to send anything in, I'll give you the P.O. box in a second. All right. And so I'll open that in a minute. If you want to join in, we can open the phone lines now, I think. You can Skype in. My Skype username is United Kingdom Radio. Okay? Actually, we'll just use the Skype for now. Okay, Skype in United Kingdom Radio. We'll do a couple of messages coming in at the moment. Good morning to Suko in New York. And says she's no problem watching the video there. Good. Doesn't Vicky live in Pennsylvania? Oh, does she? Oh, hang on, have I got the wrong one there? Oh, Vicky, sorry. Did I say Hollywood? I do apologise. No, I always confuse you, Vicky, with Jennifer for some reason. Sorry, dear. It's not you who sent anything in, is it? It's Jennifer who sent... Oh, I'm getting so confused. So confused. Okay, so the Skype in once again is United Kingdom Radio. Vicky says, good morning, Chris. She says, Daily Mail was my favourite. Even when I would visit the UK, I have a Daily Mail here. Do you want me to send you a Daily Mail in a post and you can frame it? You'll have to send your address in and I'll be happy to do that for you, my love. She says, Bulletin, I took the cover off the PC last night, dragged it outside and used a can of air to clean out the dust and cat hair. It works perfectly now. Oh, yes, that's the thing. You see, you've got a fan on the back of your computer, which is very, very susceptible to having bits of hair and fluff getting stuck in it. Do be very careful, dear, OK? Be very, very careful. Suko wants to talk to Ronnie. I don't know if... I don't think he's going to come out, actually. I'm not quite sure he's going to come out. OK. Right, we've got a phone call then. Mikey Holt's on the line.
Good evening.
Good morning, Mikey. Do you want to turn off your video? Oh, hello. Look at you sitting there. Have you got your pyjamas off?
No.
On rather?
It's a T-shirt.
Looks like pyjamas to me.
Oh, it's a T-shirt.
Good God. Morning, Mikey. Well, that's good. That's brilliant. That is brilliant. How nice to see you there. How are you?
I'm good. I thought since you're back, I'd be in video.
Nice to hear your little voice. Well, your video's working fine. Are we all sounding all right today?
Yep, yeah, sounding and looking fine.
Look at this. I've got a shirt on and everything today. You wouldn't believe it, would you? just a minute. What's Vicky saying here? Sorry, Vicky lives in New York, not Pennsylvania, Suko. I think Suko might have disappeared now. She's probably gone to work. Mikey, do you mind if I just open this box? Look, someone sent me this.
Yeah, I'm watching.
Look at this. If you want to send a postcard, maybe you're going on a holiday or something like that, then you can do so. We have a postal address. Now, I'm not sure. Mikey, what do you reckon? Shall I keep this post office box? Because I've just got the renewal fee. How much do you think it costs to have a post office box here in the UK?
How is this per month, per year?
Per year.
£450?
£90. £90 for a year. And then that's just after box, okay? If you then want it delivered here, it's another £30 a year. And I'm not sure if it's worth it or not, to be honest, because it's a hell of a lot of money, don't you think?
Well, it's a lot less than I thought.
Oh, really? Did you think it was about £400 or £500?
Yeah, I thought it would be quite expensive, because that's what you get with all the professional businesses and the BBC. They all have PO boxes.
Do you want to read this out?
Send me it in a message.
Can you not see that?
Hang on.
Are we a bit laggy? Are we a bit behind?
Just send it in a Skype message.
You can't see it. I thought you was watching my video.
I am, but it's a couple of seconds behind.
Oh, is it? Right, okay.
It's just coming on.
Oh,
right,
oh.
You can email.
All right, go on, read it out. If you want to send anything in, here you go, Mikey.
You send it to Chris Reardon, care of United Kingdom Talk, PO Box. Oh, you just took it off.
I'll hold it up a bit longer.
PO Box 4073. Is that it?
Yes.
Bracknell, Berkshire, England.
Can't you see the bit at the bottom?
You're just drinking your tea now.
Oh, am I? Oh, sorry, yeah. It's, okay. Chris Reardon, United Kingdom Talk, PO Box 4073, Bracknell, B-R-A-C-K-N-E-L-L, RG429ED, United Kingdom. All right, once again, Chris Reardon, United Kingdom Talk, PO Box 4073, Bracknell, B-R-A-C-K-N-E-L-L, RG429ED, United Kingdom. Okay, now I don't know what this is, what's in this. This is from someone who watches the show and joins us regularly, the lovely Jennifer, and I've got an email here from Jennifer. She keeps chickens.
All right.
Yep, she actually keeps chickens. Not only does she keep chickens, they're in the house. She's got nappies for these. I'm not joking here. She actually has nappies for the chickens so that they don't mess everywhere. And the chickens sit with her daughter, Dallas, okay, and the cat on the settee watching the television. And I'm absolutely serious in that. I'm not lying. You fancy a couple of chickens round your house?
No, thanks.
Eh? Well, you're up in Lincolnshire.
House isn't big enough.
Well, you're in Lincolnshire, aren't you? Haven't you all got farms and all that up there?
Only in the countryside.
Have you? Oh, my God. Wait till you see what's in here, Mikey. I can't believe how much she's sent here. Just a minute. Let's get this box open. I can't quite get this open. A pair of scissors. I'm using scissors, Mikey. Now, if you're going to use scissors to do anything, please get a parent to help you.
I'm 15, like, Chris. I know how to use a pair of scissors.
Would you like to see me trim my eyelashes? Look. No? Okay. 15! What? Not too young to have a pair of scissors?
Well, I've been using scissors for years.
Eh? Well, perhaps
cutting paper and...
I hope they're the plastic ones. Do you remember those plastic scissors that you got in primary?
Oh, they were awful. They couldn't cut through.
I know.
Toffee.
Couldn't cut through. Blimey, look at this. Look what she sent me here. Oh, wow. Oh, you're going to have to wait till you see the picture. I have got a box full of sweets. Unbelievable.
American sweets.
I've got... What did you say?
Are they American sweets?
Yes. We've got Keebler.
Oh, I can see that. Oh, love. That's a massive box.
This is massive. I can't believe this. I've got... 100 calorie right bites. Is she saying I'm fat?
It still looks. I've took over the thing now. Took over the delay.
Oh, okay. I've got...
look like little chocolate chip cookies.
They are. I've got... I don't know what these are. They look, is this dog food? Something to do with Kellogg's ear. Hang on a minute. Oh, yeah. Suko's still in bed. What a... Well, I'm not surprised. Ronnie's only just got up.
It's like 6 in the morning. Ooh, what? Oh, they're biscuits.
Oh, they're not...
Cookies, as they call them.
Well, they don't feel... They feel a bit soft. Kellogg's... Hang on, I can't read this.
I think they're like a biscuity thing.
I can't read what this says now.
Oh, if you can't read, then you fruit, need some glasses.
I've got glasses somewhere. Where are they? Fruit-flavoured snacks. Just a minute. Let me just call my mate. Ron, could you do me a little favour? You know that pair of awful glasses in the living room? On the table? Could you bring them up for me? Please, why aren't you listening? I can hear music on. You get no support from friends, Mikey. Have you noticed that over the years?
Yeah.
You just can't get any support from friends. Yeah, he might make an appearance now. Let's see if he comes into the room. If I sit over here, he'll have to lean over to give them to me, you see. Thank you. Are you coming in and saying hello? People want to say hello. Won't say hello, right. Don't laugh.
We see his hand.
Don't laugh, please. Right, OK.
We could see his hand, but that was it.
I know. What's it say? Oh, yes. Fruit flavour... Don't laugh at the glasses. Don't... No, you said you wouldn't. Fruit...
That was before I saw them properly.
Fruit-flavoured snacks, naturally and artificially flavoured. Oh, this is lovely, isn't it? We've got these. I can't believe how many sweets... Oh... Now you're talking.
I think she's trying to tell you something. She's sending you all, like, healthier stuff.
Now you're talking. Oh. Look at these. Rice crispy treats.
I love those.
We'll have some of that. I've got sandwich crackers made with peanut butter. Oh, this is marvellous. Is there a note? Oh, there's a note in here as well. Let's read the note. I can't believe how many sweets. Look at this box. This is, I've never had so many sweets in all my life, dear. Never had so many sweets.
She certainly went to town on buying sweets.
Sake, yeah. We'll put these over here for a minute. Are you coming to say hello? Yeah, wash the floor. That's it. Wash that floor. Work harder. She says, hello, Chris. Here's a sample of the box I was going to send you. Enjoy, but don't eat all in one sitting. Yes, because, and I'll tell you why. Oh, thank you. How lovely. Thank you very, very much, Jennifer.
That's I'd hate to know what the actual big box is, if that's just a sample.
She did send a huge box. She was going to send a huge box. And then she told me she wasn't going to send it straight away because it was going to cost so much. And I said to her, don't send it. You know, I would take pleasure... If anyone was going to do that, I would rather you sat there and ate the cookies yourself and took pictures and sent those in. I really would. Because, you know, don't be spending money sending stuff in, you know, if it's a lot of money. Especially, I know things are a little bit tight at the moment and what have you. Now, Mikey, computers. Did you hear the...
that was one of the things I wanted to talk about, but you spent so long doing all the emails and
This show isn't just about like you're doing banging on the callers one at a time or anything like that, dear.
Chris, you should do 2 hours because
I can't afford
then you got time for people to get on.
They can't afford me for 2 hours. They can just about afford the 1 hour. I'm the only person that gets paid for this show.
I could put aside a biro for you.
£85,000 per every time I do a show. Right, I can just buy another house.
Well, can you buy me one?
Do you know how some people they collect stamps or boxes or. There was one bloke on the radio, he rung in a radio station, LBC, the other night. Do you know what he collects? The insides of toilet rolls. Don't ask me what all that's about.
The cardboard bits.
He collects the insides of toilet rolls. Yes.
Oh.
How weird is that? What do you collect? Anything? I bet you collect something. You must collect jingles. You collect jingles, don't you?
Bits of music.
Bits of music. What else?
To be honest, I'm not really a collector.
Okay. I collect houses.
I'm just send me the deed to all my. I could take it off your hands for free.
I'm only joking. Oh, Suka, just a minute. I've got
quite a few CDs.
I've got to give a message to Ron. Ron? Suka is sending her love.
One moment, please.
Right. Sorry about that.
Ding dong.
Anyway, you were saying about computers. Oh, do you know, it's 8 minutes to... Oh, you were... sorry, you were saying about doing 2 hours. I haven't got the time to do 2 hours, to be honest. However, as you heard, my whole idea of doing this was to combine the live show and the recorded show together.
So you can do more than one.
And, you know, we're 10 minutes away from the end now, and I feel it's worked. I'm quite happy with how this has gone today. Although, you know, I've got so many emails here that I haven't done yet, OK? And I'm quite pleased with how this has worked.
That's a lot of emails.
So I think what we will do is the Thursday recorded show will now also be live as from now. So we'll do another one. We'll do 11 o'clock Tuesdays and Thursday mornings. I am also surprised at the amount of people that have joined in this morning, because I thought 11 o'clock in the morning, oh, not such a good time perhaps. But then, of course, you know, you can get it on your mobile phones and things like that now. So,
yeah.
So I think we're going to, I think that's what I'll do. I think we'll do a live show every Tuesday and Thursday at 11 o'clock UK time.
Yeah.
All right.
That's good. That's good.
Right. Computers, Mikey.
Yes, computers.
Talk to me, computers.
You're saying about what did you do before computers?
Yeah.
Well, I've had computers around, obviously, because I grew up in the mid 90s and the early 2000s. I've had computers around me all my life. I mean, I've had like consoles and computers and stuff since I was about 5.
What was your first game console, Michael?
I think it was a Game Boy Color.
Game Boy Color. Oh, my word. I think my son... Do you know I've got a son?
Have you?
Yeah, I've got a... Well, he's 26 now, and there's no contact at all, I'm afraid. But, yeah, at that point, I was able to see him then. And... yeah, he had a Game Boy Color. Loved it. It was always on this thing. We went to a few little outings, not many, but when I had the kind of access.
Always took the Game Boy.
Yeah, and he was he would have been, I think he was about, how old was he then? About 7, 8, 9.
Right.
Yeah.
When I had mine, I was about 4.
Oh, really? Blimey, yeah. that's young, isn't it? So, I mean, these things have always been around, haven't they? My my first one was a Sega. Sega? Sega?
Sega.
That's it, yeah.
Sega and Mega Drive.
That's the one. I had a Sega Mega Drive. Sega! Oh, don't start playing a bit. Oh, do that again, yeah.
You say we don't play it, do it again. Okay, then.
Yeah, I had one of those. So, sorry, I've interrupted you. Carry on, Mikey. Carry on.
Yeah, well, I got my like Game Boy when I was about 4, and I got a proper games console, a PlayStation 2.
Yeah.
And then I got my computer about I was about 9.
Oh yeah.
And they were that was on like Windows Millennium Edition. Worst operating system.
Oh, don't even go there. Did I have a computer with it on it? I can't remember now.
I did.
I think I did. But we went on to XP. Was XP the next one?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, remove that. Oh, it was a nightmare. Absolute nightmare. It was always going wrong. Just got a couple of emails here before you carry on. Now, I completely forgot to do the emails as they come in. Jennifer. Hello, Jennifer. I'm watching you live. This is a stretch. Been sitting in my chair for 15 minutes and I could have showered already. Got to run, but I'm listening. Why is Ronnie so shy? Well, believe me, he is not shy. I don't know why, but I can't get him in here to talk on the camera. And hello to Brenda. Good morning, Brenda. See, I haven't forgotten you. She says, good morning, I'm listening. Good morning, Brenda. Nice to have you with us. And Jennifer says, what does Ronnie do for a living that he can spend $100 on a show? Yeah, I'd like to know that, actually. I don't know where the money comes from, to be honest. I really don't know where the money comes from. And Suko, we've done the Suko messages as well. So that's cool. Carry on, Mikey.
Yeah, so, well, when we were on Millennium Edition, it was obviously the family computer. Then we got XP, and then about a year later, I actually got my own computer.
Right.
Oh, that was an experience.
What was that? What make was that? Do you remember?
It was Medion, I think.
Don't remember? Median. Median.
Yeah, I think it was one of those. Because that's pretty much, they're like, because obviously they're cheap, like you get them from Aldi.
Okay.
They're pretty much the main computers we've had. But then very, very recently, for my 15th birthday,
I was in Aldi the other day, and I didn't find their laptops particularly cheap, to be honest.
Well, they used to be.
Right, okay.
Well, we're talking about desktops. I've never actually owned a laptop.
Okay, right.
So, yeah, and then I had my own computer. And to be honest, I had that for a few years, so it was getting a bit pants. And for my 15th birthday, I got a brilliant computer.
Go on.
Well, would you like me to describe the specs?
Yes, I would, yeah.
6 gigabytes of RAM.
Right.
1 terabyte dedicated, no, 1 terabyte video memory, 1 gigabyte of video memory, 1 terabyte hard drive, and it's going to last me for a long time as
well. That's a big old one, that one. What make is that, Mike?
It's a Packard Bell.
Okay, good make, yeah, good make, yeah. Yeah, the actual computer that runs United Kingdom Talk Audio Stream is also a Packard Bell. I got it at a very good price. I had the monitor already, and it only comes as a package. I'm not interested then. And he was so upset that he couldn't sell me a monitor and all the other bits and pieces. I said, all I want is the box. That's it. That's all I want. So I managed to get it $400. That's the machine.
Well, this is. I've got the only thing that came with it. I had the tower and a keyboard and mouse.
Oh, okay.
Because the monitor I'm running it off is actually a HD TV. It's 19-inch.
Lovely.
It's very, very well.
That is nice. All right, Mikey, shall I let you go because we're nearly finished now?
Yeah, there was other stuff I wanted to talk about, but I can wait till Thursday.
Lovely to see you. Yeah, we'll do again Thursday at 11 o'clock. I'm quite happy doing this now. Yeah, once you've done it a couple of times and the technology has held up today, which is a change, isn't it? Don't look so serious. Smile now and again. That's better. is that a new microphone stand you got there?
It's just a...
What have you got? Oh, one that stands...
It's a tabletop thing.
Is it on the floor or on the table?
So it's on the table.
Yeah, that's perfect. Why do you want to buy another one?
With another one, I can. This is really static.
But it works. It works. Listen to me. Learn this, right? Buy things that you need, not things that you want. Okay? You may need something.
I could probably do with a new microphone, because this one's got a lot of slight static noise. And it's
sounds
not,
fine
it's
to
not
me, mate.
Noise.
It's not the microphone. It sounds fine. It's perfect. Listen, everything then. About you is perfect. Not as perfect as me, but you're okay. You're okay. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
See you later, Mikey. Love to your family,
you
all right? Bye-bye. There we are. Little Mikey Holt from Grant from there. We're almost out of time. Just got one more message to do here from Mark. Hello, Mark, who says, have been listening, Chris. Haven't listened for a while. Yeah, where have you been? Where have you been, eh? Okay, well, I'm going to disappear now. Sorry, I'm just working out how to do a couple of new things here. What do I have to do next? Oh, I'm not quite sure what I'm doing next. Oh, I know what I've got to do there. There we are. That's the end of the show today. Thank you very, very much for joining me. You can contact me outside the show times. My email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. And the emails, as you heard at the beginning of the show, we do bring those into the show again. You can go back to any of the old shows and bring up any old subject that you want to. Okay, once again, my email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Now, I've foolishly rather forgotten to get my little bit of music here that I finished with. All right, see you on the next show next Thursday morning. What time is it? Next Thursday morning, this Thursday morning at 11 o'clock. Thanks very much for watching. Bye-bye.